Hi, welcome to my desk. My name is Ashley, and we are about to work together for 1 hour. I hope you brought a task, a project, something you want to sink your teeth into, because we are going to sit down together and do a full hour in real time. We're going to use the Pomodoro technique, which means we'll do 2 25-minute work sections. During the work sections, I will blast white noise, and we will both focus on whatever it is we want to accomplish today. Right in the middle, we'll have a 5-minute break where you can get up and stretch, maybe refill your beverages, maybe do some quick tailoring on a clothing item. Do whatever you want. Take that time for yourself. It is a break. But if you want a little human interaction, stay with me. I will be chatting, as always, about a certain subject. And then after the break, we'll do our second 25-minute work section. And then after that, guess what? We are done for the day. We can close our computers. We can go out into the world. We can live our lives with the knowledge, with the security, with the confidence of someone who already woke up, who already sat down, who already took care of business. How does that sound? Great. So today I'm drinking a hot coffee with almond milk, a classic, a banger in this house, one might say. And for the first 25 minutes, I'm going to be working on a short story. I would love to know what you're going to work on and what beverages you have. Wonderful. Well, without further delay, let's jump into this first 25 minutes. It flies by. If you get bored, if you get lonely, you can look up and you can see that I am right there with you, chugging along. Let's make sure everything's where we want it. Our desk area feels good. It's comfortable. Picard, Riker, and Q are there silently cheering us on. Everything's how we want it. You ready? Okay, here we go. I'll talk to you soon. 3, 2, 1. Go. Ding, ding, ding. The sweet tones of the old chimes. I'm putting 5 minutes on the clock. Why don't you give me a big old stretch? Yeah, move the body around. Shift the torso. Rock back and forth on those hips. Ooh, going in and out of focus. That's fun. You know, last week I made a mistake when I was recording, and I saved the recording of this video to the cloud. And then when I got it back, it was super, super blurry. And it was last Wednesday's video. I had a lot of technical difficulties last week. It was very blurry, and I added a little surprise caption there to let people know that it was blurry. Not on purpose. I didn't do it on purpose. Just a mistake. Just Ashley being not smart. You know, my brain, I have like moving brain, okay? Which is very similar to breakup brain or sick brain. It's when it's hard to focus on anything but the one task at hand, which for me is currently moving across the country. Anyway, it was still there. I still worked Wednesday morning with you guys, but it was blurry and someone gave it a down vote. Someone gave it a thumbs down, which should not affect me at all because what is the internet? But there's only a handful of us that work together every morning or every day. So I was like, I wonder if we're just going to assume it was just a rogue person that stumbled across the video for the first time. But if it was you and you're like a regular, I just want you to know I didn't do that on purpose. I'm sorry if it ruined your experience. But this is a good time to let everybody know. If you want to give me a thumbs up, I would appreciate it. I love a thumbs up. Sometimes I give myself thumbs up. Yeah, I'm not afraid to say it. So when I was talking in the beginning, you know, my little intro, my little spiel, and I said the thing about going to tailor your clothes, it is because I'm wearing this shirt and I love this shirt. It's got this cute little moon on it. I don't know if you can tell. The company is, I'm going to find out the company for you and let you know at the end of the video. But the shirt is just like so well made. It's just a classic cotton shirt, but I love the cut of it. I love the feel. It's just a quality shirt. Unfortunately, it is merch for a podcast that I used to love. And the podcast name is printed on this pocket. You can't read it. Thankfully, you cannot read it and you cannot see it, thankfully. And I say thankfully because I used to love this podcast so much and it was a wellness podcast. I might have talked about this on the channel before because it was like disruptive slightly. There's so many other things in life to worry about besides this, but wait a minute. Did I set a 5 minute timer? I did. Thank God. I have moving brain, so I'm forgetting to do a lot of stuff. Forgot to lock the car the other night. Anyway, that's not the point. I love this podcast so much. And then one of the hosts came out pretty hard against the vaccine in a way that was shocking to me. It's a wellness podcast. It's like LA based and it's a little fluffy. It's a little fluffy. You know, she was saying things like she wasn't going to get the vaccine because her astrologer predicted that there would be a big advancement in the winter of 2022, and that was probably a new vaccine. And like, just it, I used to listen to it mainly for the yoga chats and the mindfulness chats. But wow, she came out so hard against the vaccine on her Instagram. And you could tell that the other host was pissed because they had like a couple of very veiled episodes where it was like how to do business with someone when you do not agree on a very core issue, and it was like clear that they were working through their stuff. But I just stopped listening to it because I was like, oh, that's too bad, I can't support it. I unsubscribed. And then like a couple of weeks ago I went back to see what was going on with it, to see if they were still putting out episodes, and they shut down the podcast. Like, this podcast has been going on for like 6 or 7 years. Time is up. Podcast has been going on for 6 or 7 years, and they shut it down in the matter of a few months of her coming out against the vaccine, because I think they shut it down back in like July. I just haven't, it's not been on my radar because I stopped listening to it, but I want to get a little seam cutter and take this pocket off so you can't read the name if I'm out in public, because I do love the shirt so much. I'm going to tell you the company because they make really nice clothes and they just happen to do like a collaboration with this podcast. Anyway, that's my little chit chat for the day. Let's do another 25 minutes of work. I am going to keep working on what I'm working on. I would love to know what you're going to work on. Great. Well, I'll put 25 minutes on the clock. Get comfortable. Feel good. I'm impressed with us. Okay, here I go. You ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Interesting. Would you look at that? Would you look at that? Wow. We did it, folks. It is a wonderful Friday. We can go out and live our lives. We can feel good. We can call our mom and tell her, do you know what I just did? I just worked for 1 hour with my internet friends on something that I wanted to get done. Have a great weekend. I hope you relax. I hope you feel rejuvenated. I hope you get in whatever it is you want to do to make this weekend mwah, perfecto. Oh, I was going to find the brand of this shirt. And then I got too busy editing my short story and I totally forgot. I'll tell you on Monday. Do you care? We'll find out. I'll tell you on Monday. That is for sure. You know what? Let me just look it up right now. What am I even talking about? I will look it up right now. Surely it's in my emails. Let's find out. I'm only telling you because I love the company is called 4 days, F-O-R days, 4 days. And you can like buy a shirt and then recycle it, send it in, get a new one. I really like it. Unfortunately, they did do a collaboration with this podcast and now I have to take the pocket off to keep the shirt, but that's how life goes sometimes. Anyway, thank you so much. I really appreciate you. I'll see you on Monday at 10 a.m. Bye.